Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I want to talk about gun belts. This is the foundation to any carry system. The reason why I want to talk about this is because recently I was at a range and I noticed these two individuals walking around the range open carrying, and they were constantly touching their holster, pulling up their pants, readjusting their holster, pulling up their pants constantly. And upon closer inspection, I noticed their belt was of some type of thin material or a dress belt that you would buy at, say, Wally World, Gap, Bob's, or whatever said clothing store. It was obviously not a belt made to carry any type of weight. So, of course, they're going to be constantly adjusting their holster and their pants are falling down. So it kind of made me think, you know, being in this game since the late 90s until 2015, present day, I can't tell you how many times I've met somebody or a guy that, for whatever reason, does not want to invest in a good gun belt. And I kind of understand that because some of these guys are saying, I mean, why would I spend all this money on a belt, you know, when I can put that money towards a new gun I want or a nice holster? And I get it, but you got to invest in a good foundation, a belt. Once you do that, you'll be set for many, many years if you get a good quality belt. You put that money into it, it's an investment. And you're going to get your return, trust me. So these guys at the range were constantly like tugging on their pants. I think one guy had a Kimber, it was the Kimber Warrior, I think, Desert Warrior, because it had that that sand color or puke colored Cerakote. And of course, I mean, a 1911, a 2 pound plus pistol, you got this, you know, on your belt, of course it's going to weigh things down and the grip's going to pop out because the belt that they're using, the flimsy belt, cannot accommodate that weight. So it's just physics. And the other guy was carrying, like, I think it was like a CZ type pistol, and same thing. It was just like, I mean, the way it was like pulling his pants down was kind of like comical. So you don't want to go in that direction. And I know you guys watching this know this, but I just felt like just talking about this video because you guys probably know someone that just doesn't want to get a good foundation because they feel they don't want to spend that money, you know, on something like this. When, like I said, when they can put it towards a new gun or another holster or ammunition or whatever. But like I said, once you get a good belt, good quality belt, I prefer leather. I mean, there's a lot of these new high-tech nylon type belts that are pretty much working out for everybody out there, but I like leather. Once you get this, you're going to be gold. You're going to be set. You're going to be able to conceal your weapon. It's going to be able to accommodate a heavy weapon, and yeah, you'll be good to go. Like I said, some of these belts here I want to show you guys is, as an example, this one right here is a Milt Sparks belt. Now this one here, I got this one in 2002, all right? And back in 2002, this probably ran about, I don't know, 70 bucks around. Now 2002 to 2015, you guys do the math, it's lost a lot of its dye. I mean, you know, it looks kind of like, you know, seen better days. But guys, the belt still works. All right, it might be getting a little more flimsy, but it still works. This thing can still hold a 1911, and that there's a testament to Milt Sparks. You spend the money, and how many years is that? And that's a good investment on a return right there. So, really good belt, Milt Sparks, works out very well. Zach's gun belts. This one here is actually, look how thick this belt is. All right. The only problem with this belt is it doesn't fit some of my holsters because of how thick the belt is, such as this Lobo right here. So if you stick this through here and try to loop it, as you can see, when it tries to go through the second loop right here, it can barely make it. It's just too thick. See that? It's just too thick. But it's a good belt. So if you have a holster that can accommodate this thickness, go for it because this is an extremely sturdy belt that can accommodate a lot of weight. This belt here is pretty nice. It's made by Comtac, and it has a piece of kydex sewn in here to keep its rigidity. This is one I'm using a lot right now, and it works out extremely well. I think it's reasonably priced, so this might be something you guys want to look at. But again, this can hold up a pretty good amount of weight, such as a 1911, with no problem. So once you have a good foundation, a good holster, you got a great concealed carry system right there. Everything will work out. You'll be able to conceal. You know, things won't be printing. You're not going to be tugging on your pants and touching your gun side all the time, which may cause some, you know, attention drawn towards you. And I would just be curious what you guys think about a good system. other people out there may be interested in other brands, such as those nylon high-tech type belts. I'm not really familiar with them. A lot of people ask me about these certain brands. I really don't have much to say about them because I don't use them. I had an Aries gun belt once. I just didn't like it. You know, that's just not my thing. But I know tons of guys at the range that have that Aries belt or whatever, and they love it, and it works out for them. They carry 1911s and stuff like that. So you guys can leave some thoughts and suggestions below for everyone to kind of ponder over. Let me know what you think about all this, because I'd be curious. And that's basically all I want to talk about. Get a good foundation first, and then look at some, you know, nice holsters. Foundation, holster, gun, you'll be all set to go. All right, guys, leave some comments below, and as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.